Some other areas may call collect. The opinions expressed by the host, guests, or callers are not necessarily those of the station. Now, here's Neil Rogers on News Talk Radio 610 WIOD.
I'm a Cub fan and a Bud man, and I trust you are too.
Here's Jeff Pitt. There's a long drive, deep center field. Way back, it might be.
I wonder how the Mets fans slept last night. 10:06 at WIOD. I'm not going to rub it in. We don't have to have a big timid about it because we have two anti-sports people in the studio today, and they get really surly. We have Johnny Dark with a different shirt on today. Okay, I wouldn't say it's a new shirt because it's badly wrinkled, but it is a different shirt. So that's something. That's a step in the right direction. Anyway, here we are again, right? We got lunch coming from Wings Plus today, which is why Johnny is here, of course. And I see that Andy and Todd are both still in the building at the moment, which means they might actually come in and have a little lunch. Probably the big shots are out of town again or something, because they don't like that. They don't want these interns schmoozing around in here. They want them out there working their butts off, okay?
Oh.
Also, we have racing at Calder again today after the weekly two dark days on Monday and Tuesday. Phil will be pleased to know that we are not picking in the first two races, so we don't have to be embarrassed again. Well, you got to get the lay of the land. Sixth race, I'm going with another Jewish horse, Matt's Shtick, with Gonzalez. Why is it Mike rides all these Jewish horses? Wonder what's going on there. And then in the ninth race, in the featured Delray Prep, Mr. Bird is picking Atlanta National, ridden by Steve Gaffalione.
Tough.
Yeah. Can I get some lighter or some matches, do you think? I don't want Roger to have to come in here because he's overworked already. But it's really difficult. I don't want to get Steve upset because he's very anti-smoke unless he's smoking a cigar. Then he doesn't mind it at all. I do want to say this. I didn't hear much of that show yesterday, the juniors, but when I was driving to my mother's for dinner, I heard this goofball call in, and Steve called him a subhuman douchebag.
Wow.
Yeah, look at that, Henry.
Well, I tried to listen to that show over and over yesterday.
Henry Barrow just serviced my cigar. I beg your pardon? Well, that's an interesting way of putting it. What did you say?
Well, I had trouble. I tried to listen to that show many times.
Now, you're not going to rip Steve, are you?
No, nothing to do with
all
Steve.
All I did was say he said subhuman douchebag, and I almost drove off the road.
But I didn't. I had trouble with the show. That's all I'm saying.
You had trouble with the show?
I had trouble with it.
Well, obviously he did, too.
Yeah. So, I was desperate, you know?
Well, his Chinese thing kind of petered out, you know?
So I punched over to Alice. Guess what he was doing yesterday?
You know, the rumor has it that Marco Polo was hung like a butterfly. Okay, Alice was doing what?
Drinking urine.
Again?
And
not again.
And these old fossils were calling up, "Oh, Alice, it's wonderful. You should drink your urine. Trust me, it'll help you." Oh, my God.
I wish we had TV. There's a thing out of USA Today that Roger gave me here. It says New Jersey may sign up for elderly crossing.
What?
And it's got a new traffic symbol, and they're trying to work it out. The senior citizens are very upset about this because it shows two doddering old figures with canes schlepping across the street.
Boy.
Now, what I like, it says creating a new sign could take anywhere from 2 to 5 years. Don't you like the way the government spends our money? Could take 2 to 5 years. What they might want to do is have like a kind of a figure of Claude lying in his casket.
That's a thought.
Yeah. That's kind of a warning that this could happen to you, you know. And it could say Hallandale Beach Boulevard on the street sign. Something creative like that. Anyway, it's 9:09 at WIOD. I wonder if our lady friend from Cooper City is listening today. Because the good news is we have it. I got the cart right in my hand. But I'm not going to play it. Unless she's listening, okay?
Yeah, good idea. Yeah.
Bill Deal and the Rondells. And you said to Spike Wise this morning, take a look at this. And he looked at the label and he said, "What's that?"
Blank. No idea.
That
no
man
clue.
Knows his music. I don't want to go out on a limb, okay? Like picking Northern Wolf in the Preakness.
Yeah.
I don't want to go out on a limb, but I'd say he almost knows his music as well as Rose Folger.
Wow. Now.
I know that's pretty revolutionary statement, but I would say it's pretty damn close, okay?
God.
Anyway, that Broward number is 524-WIOD, and if that young lady from Cooper City who called yesterday is listening, I don't want to play it unless she's listening. Now, she's probably in a car somewhere right now, frantic.
Mm-hmm.
But we'll wait a little while, okay? And if she's listening, I want to make sure she gets to hear it, because she was nice, wasn't she?
Very.
I bet you that's her right now. Ooh. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Hello. Oh, I know what I did wrong. I didn't do these yet. Oh, boy, this is the best. Hello.
Yeah, I'd like to talk with Neil this morning.
Oh, that's the young lady from Cooper City. Hold on, pal. Don't go away now. What a bummer. Is she on there? Hello?
Hello?
I'll be darned.
I turned it on just in time.
Boy, that's loyalty, isn't it?
Sure is.
You are incredible. Well, I'm sorry that yesterday we led you down the path the whole show, and then some caller to Steve ripped me yesterday for spending all that time, wasting all this time searching for records.
I can't believe you took so long, that you took that time to look for it.
Well, I'll be honest with you, I was desperate, you know, because he really wanted to hear it, and I knew it, and I still can't find it. That's the amazing part. I mean, I got the song thanks to Johnny Dolan, but I can't find my CD, so evidently somebody ripped it off.
Oh, no.
So somebody else must like Bill Deal and the Rondells, too.
I guess so.
Yeah. Well, I'm going to play it right after the break, okay? I'm going to do a little break, and then we'll play it. I'm just tickled to death that you're listening. If nobody else is listening, the fact that you are makes it worthwhile.
Oh, okay. Thanks, Neil.
Have a great day.
You too. Bye.
Isn't that nice?
Amazing.
It was, because she's nice.
Yeah.
And there's so few people in this town who are nice that it's shocking, as Ranieri would say. It's shocking. Anyway, it's 12 minutes past 10 at WIOD. Do you believe he's having Clocker Sidney back on again Friday? Before the Belmont? See, one thing about Mike is he just cannot say no. You know, he knows in his mind.
God.
He knows that some of these Jalieris really need to be put on the bus with Boy Gary to Louisville or anywhere. But he just is too soft-hearted and he can't say no. Mm. You do hear him whimpering in the background, though, but... Alta Clocker Sidney is going to be picking. If he does as well in the Belmont as he did with the Preakness, I would run to the bank right now, make a huge withdrawal, okay? Anyway, and of course, after the race, he'll be making a gigantic deposit. I don't want to say where. Kind of like my dogs.
Mm-hmm.
Telstar 34. Now, that was worth waiting for, wasn't it, sir?
Oh, yeah, real worth waiting for.
Okay.
She sounds like she's waiting for Alice's show.
She's got a box out of Calder, and of course, so does Claude Pepper.
I think Claude has a box under Calder.
Well, something like that.
Anyway, to continue what I was saying, sports talk last night. Little sports talk spy report.
Mm-hmm.
When the UM game was continually delayed because of the long college baseball game before it, Hank got bored of talking sports and started reading the rack.
Hank Goldberg was talking tonight about how much he likes you, by the way.
Oh, Hank's one of my favorite people.
Yeah. Wanted to ask you...
They don't come any better than Hank Goldberg.
Go ahead, sir.
Yeah, he was reading the cart rack to a caller. He thought he was reading yours, and he was reading... what's his name?
Rogers.
Yeah.
Hmm.
Now, he was reading all the stuff from before you, and then he started reading through your cart rack and played Vatican Rag.
Did he?
Yeah, he did.
Well, that's great.
That was good for sports talk.
Yeah. Well, even the Pope is a sports fan, you know?
Well, I guess he would be, wouldn't he?
Sure.
One more point for you. If you change the words around in Geraldo's name, you get real dog.
Okay.
Good day.
Have a great day, pal.
I see what you mean about this being a
excellent
really
show today. Very educational. You're going to learn a lot.
Barn burn.
10:35. We have two open lines in Dade County. I don't understand that. Must be some kind of another one of those foreign festivals. 751-9463. 751-WIOD. And no matter what language you speak, you're going to love the delicious food at Char Hut because it's fresh. It's made with the best ingredients. They use only prime ground chuck. And they grind that chuck every stinking day, man. They don't bring you stuff that's been frozen or sitting around. It's as fresh as can be, just like their sausage. They grind those pork butts fresh every day. And they even take the bone and skin off their chicken every day. And then they grill it for you fresh the way you want it with all the toppings that you love. And they even offer you Kaiser rolls for your sandwich. So when you get it like an Italian sausage there with all the things I like on it, it's an entire meal, not just like a little tease to your appetite, okay? So instead of the fast food, junk food joints, you head for the great place, Char Hut. There are seven in South Florida. And don't forget the official Neil Rogers Char Hut refillable squeeze bottle will be available starting July 1st, okay, in spite of what any rumors you may have heard. There are 7 char huts, and they're open right now for early lunch in Fort Lauderdale, Sunrise, Tamarack, Davie, Hollywood, Miami, and the newest char hut at 306 North State Road 7 in Margate. Okay, we got an open line in Dade at 751 WIOD. Now, what were you about to say, nighttime radio? What is that? We got another mobile? Okay, we'll get back to Johnny Johnson's analysis of the market in a second, but we got a mobile on it. Well, we got to get to these people who are spending a lot of money to speak to us, right, sir?
You got it, Neil.
Okay.
Hey, I caught that little piece last night, too.
Did you? You caught a little piece last night. Well, congratulations, sir.
It's about time.
Yeah.
Hey, I caught the bird in the background there. Not to get personal, bird, but I can help. They say if you massage your head, it'll grow back.
They do say that.
It's right. Constant massage. You got to massage it. It will grow back.
You got to massage it. It'll grow back. How about your head?
Well, that's a different story.
I see.
Govern yourself.
Okay.
One more spy report on the colonel this morning.
Yeah.
Did you hear him give his birthday call?
I didn't hear any of it this morning. I missed out.
8 o'clock in the morning, calling Terry Merriman at home to wish her happy birthday.
Oh, yeah. She's got sucked in on that show, boy. Her credibility is zero at this point.
Well, he was being all excited about calling her when she was in bed.
Gonna know what we're gonna play.
Let's see if there's some interesting stuff on here, or not, as the case may be.
She lies by the ocean, resembling a beached white whale. She puts on her lotion with a mop and a giant pail. I cringe as she asks me, do I look all right? To be truthful, you've got too much cellulite.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'd give that about a 6.5.
That was good.
Okay, this could be interesting.
You found someone who loves you truer. That's not all that hurt my pride. Said my house is like a sewer. Sewer front and sewer side. You say I'm living like a caveman. Bathroom's dirty, sheets are brown.
She needs therapy. She really does. Okay, so we got the straight poop now.
Again?
On the Kane show.
Yeah, the saga.
China's bloody revolution will be the topic today. Colonel John Larson should lick. Will be one of the guests. Yim Tom.
Huh?
Yim Tom. Uh-huh. She's a Chinese-American student who loves sweet and sour pork.
Mm-hmm.
And David Daly, Oliver North's former roommate. So, boy, you put that group together.
Wow. Now that's
really
a
got
show.
Something.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it says, Yim Tom should lick David Daly. 1242 at WIOD. What happened to this thing here? It just died. Oh, I see. I probably am on the wrong cut. Do you think that makes a difference?
Sylvester Stallone's back. And this time, he's headed for number one with a bullet. Oh! It's Sly and the Family Stallone.
I want to thank you for letting me break your face again. I'm coming to get you.
Sly and the Family Stallone. Your gut will wrench as old bazooka breath warbles his way through this deluge of direct hits.
There is the white one who wants to kill the red one who wants to waste the yellow one. I kill everyday scumbags. Hot gun in the summertime. Nothing like a hot gun in the summertime. I'm coming to get you.
Sly and the Family Stallone. Available wherever semi-automatic weapons are sold.
Not bad. That was cute.
Cute?
Well, that's not the word.
Hey, kids, don't play ball. Play the odds with the Pete Rose Talking Baseball Card.
Let's go bet on a ball game and make us some big bucks. We don't care who loses or wins as long as we make the spread again.
Pete Rose Talking Baseball Card. It's fun, it's profitable, it's educational, it's illegal. The Pete Rose Talking Baseball Card will have the feds calling foul. Only $14.95 or 5 to 3 or 8 to 6. Get yours wherever racing forms are sold.
Time to talk about Wings Plus. Now, what is this from Sweden?
How you doing, Neil?
Okay.
Well, it's me, Godfather Jr., and I got a WID phone.
Didn't I tell you to get a life?
Yeah, you told me a few times to get a life, but I don't know. I figured I'd just give you a phone call and see if you give me another chance.
Okay. This is your last chance, pal.
Yeah, well, I'm coming home tomorrow, so.
Are you really?
Yeah, I'm flying in tomorrow.
Great. So how's all our Swedish friends doing over there?
They're doing good. The weather's a little gray, but, you know, things are on the up and up.
Well, there's a lot of folks who are a little gray here, too, so I guess it'll all even out when you get back.
Yeah, sounds good.
Mm-hmm.
Well, do you have any last-minute questions about Sweden before I leave?
No.
Oh, okay. Can you put me on hold for the rest of the show?
Sure, no problem. Where are you? What line are you on?
I don't know.
Line 5.
I think I got someone in the
Broward. Line 5. You might even get on the lightning round. Hold on now. You're calling Collective Course.
Of course.
Okay, hold on. Okay, 1257, that ought to run up the bill real good. Oh, boy, you're going to be all right now? I see you had another little, did you just check the mail out?
Yes, watered the flowers, and everything's fine now. I ran into someone in the hall.
Really?
When I was walking.
Not Rick Weaver.
No.
Rick Shaw?
Will you get serious? And he said to me that he's going to come in here for cross plugs. And he, as soon as he finishes Xeroxing, he'll be in here to do some cross plugs.
Oh, speaking of Rick Shaw,
were
second.
We? I just wanted to warn you about that.
Just a minute now, I got to do this right.
So you're not surprised.
I'm trying to think of what part of the record. I think it's like three. Well, we'll do it this way.
Now, you won't hear this on the Sandy Payton Show.
I'd say 345, okay?
My guess.
Listen to this.
This has got to be the Dion song.
Yeah, it is. Good video on this.
This is a good song. It's a great song.
Yeah.
Best cut on the album.
I'm right between this and Written on the Subway Wall. They're both so great. And, of course, somebody next door couldn't be the same person you're referring to who will not play the Dion cuts on GTR, which he's making a bad mistake. He's making a bad mistake.
There, right?
Huh?
The guy who takes
chances. Mr. I Live Dangerously, and I play, really heavy-duty dangerous stuff like the Beatles, you know. Here it is.
A rickshaw on a dog sled.
Boy, when I hear that, I flip my cap when I hear that. I go crazy. Anyway, I sure wish we had time to take some of these very important calls, but we got to do, he spent all his time dubbing, and we got a little digesting to do now, don't we?
Right. I like this better, actually, to do this.
What's that?
What you're going
to
do.
Oh, to let it digest and settle down, let everybody in the audience calm down. It was a very tumultuous lunch today, wasn't it?
It's at the
Wow, yeah, it was pretty, we got people in here that I never saw in the building
That's
before.
That's true. People I'd never ever laid
by. We had a line from here all the way to the causeway. It was incredible. And even Cheryl came by twice. Not once, but twice.
What does that tell
you? I'm proud of her, boy. She's got to start getting with it, you know? But I won't rest until we have Boy Gary come in one day and have food in here. Wouldn't that be something?
I wait every day. Yeah. Every day I look
just
for
have
him.
A little tidbit of something. You know, yeah. He's got a breakdown. He's got to admit that he was dead wrong. And even though it's bad radio, it's great lunch.
Yeah.
You know.
You have to make
a lot of tough decisions in life. And one of those is whether you're more concerned about bad radio or good lunch. And for me, it's not even a contest.
The 1 to 2 hour.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Putz himself is coming to the studio now.
Here's the guy who takes the chances.
Yeah. Mr. Excuse me for not having the guts to take a chance. Ozzy Osbourne, my ass. Get out of here, will you?
97
GTR. Yeah, crank it down. Crank it down and piss off the PD, okay?
I love that DR. Isn't that a smash?
This is a good song.
The only station in the market that has the balls to play a tremendous song, even if it's not on the computer list from the focus group and the consultant and the maggot study and the 75 kids up the street, you know? Isn't it amazing how people twist things around in their minds? He fired Neil Rogers.
No.
If that's the case, how come I have a letter of release from them from my contract that I had to scream and holler to get to let me out of the contract so I could come over here for almost double the money? How come that is?
I wish my mommy and daddy owned a radio station.
Yeah. How come Tim Williams has the job over there, okay?
He worked hard to get it.
As Archie Bunker would say, maybe because it's all in the family. You know what I'm saying? You douchebag. You slimeball. What an idiot. Jeez. He fired. See, even if he had, that would be one thing.
Mm-hmm.
But he didn't.
Oh.
Because that would have been too embarrassing. They didn't even fire Stan Major. They paid him off. They didn't fire him. If you fire somebody, they're just gone. If you pay somebody, you buy out their contract, that's a little bit different. But with us, we just said goodbye. In fact, I remember the day I said to Bulger, I'm leaving.
Mm-hmm.
And he said, oh? And I said, yeah.
He said, I'll pack you sandwiches.
Yeah. Oh, exactly. No. He put on a little act there in the beginning, and then there were tears in his eyes. Oh, boy, I could tell stories about that joint, man, from now till for months, all till after Shavuos.
A bitter pill.
Yeah, a bitter pill to swallow. He was doing sleaze radio. I got news for you. That show on Zeta was about as sleazy as chocolate milk, okay? That's how sleazy it was. They took every stinking thing away from us that we ever dreamed of doing. Oh, we don't want anything creative. If you're thinking of that, forget it. We just want a real safe show. And we'd rather be number three than number one. They took everything away, so how could we have been doing a sleazy show? Okay? And isn't it interesting how they got a segment now with their wonderful upright guys in the morning of things that sound dirty but aren't? And they do everything as filthy as they can possibly get away with on the air. That's okay if they do it, see? That's a good show for the entire family.
Yeah.
All right.
Can't even say some of the things.
Oh, yeah. Filthy is crap. Even Herman and McBean are embarrassed, and that's almost impossible. Okay? But it's okay if they're doing it. But we were doing it. It was a sleazy show. Yeah. And they were doing a New York Times. Is that what it means the New York Times has a 1.5 share?
I guess.
The bottom line is what you said earlier. They didn't have the
balls.
Yeah.
That's correct. Oh, it is correct. That's why they got rid of all their talk. They didn't have the stomach for it.
Yep.
Because they're a little mom-and-pop company out of Portland, Maine, who don't have any clue what this market is all about.
Zero.
They even failed in little markets, okay? They had a seller station like in Davenport, Iowa. Wasn't it? Davenport?
Yeah. Something like that.
And Oklahoma City and the Cocoa Beach. I mean, no matter where they had a station, man, they failed.
Can I do my statement about Tim Williams real quick?
Please.
When we were at
take more than 20 or 30 minutes.
I won't take long. When we were at ZTA, Gary Lawrence was the general manager. We were brutal. We ripped him to shreds every day. Now, I think everything we said about him was basically valid. However, compared to Tim Williams,
he was a brain surgeon.
Gary Lawrence is
Einstein.
A genius. That's all I want to say. That's it.
Yeah.
That's my statement.
At least Gary was a good guy.
Yes, he was.
As opposed to Tim, who walked around in that position like he had a load in his pants all the time. You know what I'm talking about? Up and down the hallway, that kind of strange... Oh, man, I'm telling you. That story there, that is the most incredible, unbelievable. You talk, and I bet you he believes it now.
Yeah.
I bet you he's twisted around in his own mind.
Big lie.
Yeah. Well, let's see. We're sitting here with about an 8 share in a sold-out show, and they're sitting over there with a 1.5 in the morning and a 1.6 on the station and the AM with a 2 with demographics that are so old.
But they're
that
thrilled.
And they're thrilled.
They got
so I'm glad
thrilled.
That you have your New York Times image, okay, and that you're starving to death over there, okay? Because you couldn't, nobody could deserve it any better. Look at that. He's so worked up about it, he's going to go check the mail again. He is. I'm telling you, that just knocked him for a loop. 23 after 1 at WID. Time to talk about one of Johnny's favorite restaurants, Trapper's Alley in Plantation, where you are going to find a delightful... Which is saying a lot. Anyway, it's 1:34, and don't forget on the Steve Kane Show today, it's Yim Tom Should Lick David Daly. That's the list. Yim Tom Should Lick David Daly. That's the list of names that Sharon gave me. Well, that's going to be like a Chinese orgy here today. That ought to start a new revolution. And Steve's going to be previewing that great new flick called I Like Fat Chinese Chicks or whatever.
Yeah, that's it.
Anyway, let me one more time remind you that on Saturday, June 24th, and by the way, the guy yesterday was a subhuman douchebag that you were referring to. I almost drove off the road when you said that. But is that the one with the eyes? The
yes.
Tall guy? Oh, he... Very, drives you nuts, and he never goes away and just hangs over the table. Him and his friend from Playoffs, the round Mr. S stands for something we can't say anything. Mr. Mung. Oh, jeez. Anyway, Saturday the 24th, we will be there without those guys or the guy with the dog.
Oh.
And if they do show up, we're going to have a special van to cart them away, okay? The same van that carts away the broken-down horses at the track is coming to cart them away. But anyway, we invite you to come out that day because we're going to have a lot. They tell us there are going to be prizes. I mean, you know, God only knows when you're dealing with Lynn in sales. But she says there are going to be fantastic prizes. And, of course, we'll have the bumper stickers and pictures. And I guarantee you tons of food there that day.
Oh, prizes and surprises.
Prizes and surprises,
yeah,
as they say in the business over at Zeta. And of course, while you're there, we want a lot of you to check out the great deals because during the summertime, man, with the summertime blues, you're going to find savings like never before on those beautiful 89 Toyotas. So kind of like make a special date on the calendar right now, okay, because we know that Lynn would never change the date on us again at this late date. Saturday, June 24th at Toyota of Hollywood on 441 between Taft and Sheridan Streets in Hollywood, right up the street from Char Hut and right across from DeSalvo's.
Hey, Neil.
Yeah.
What's happening? It's Todd in Palm Beach. Or I should say West Palm Beach.
What?
Hello?
Is that your name, Tom Palm Beach?
No.
Are you related to Tom Pompano, sir?
Hey, I'd sound like a radio personality was Todd Palm Beach. No, it's Todd.
Or Dwight Lauderdale.
It's Todd in Palm Beach.
Uh-huh.
So, hey, I got
or Harry Homestead.
There you go. Hey, I got a little song for you.
Got a little something, huh?
Can you handle
That's
it?
That's the word. Can I handle it? Well, if it's a little something, probably.
Here you go. You won't.
Okay, 1:39 at WIOD.
He was wrong.
Yeah, he was wrong. Why not?
You did.
Now, we don't need any, you know, chorus lines out here in front on the causeway. We've already got enough other action going on. And, of course, on the Steve Kane Show this afternoon, Yim Tom Should Lick David Daly. And Hank Goldberg with Sports Talk at 6:05. And then at 7:30, we got the Orioles and the Yankees. Yankees actually won a game last night, which was pretty damn exciting. And then on the Larry King Show tonight... Kevin Mitchell, 22, is it now? 22 home runs. Keep in mind, the season is just about a third over, and this guy is going at a rate. He would hit 66 home runs and drive in about 180 runs at the rate he's going right now. The guy is unconscious, okay?
In the year, I picked up 100 of his rookie cards at 60 cents a piece.
Now, you don't have him in a rotisserie league, though, do you?
I don't play that.
Oh, man, this rotisserie baseball, I'm telling you. Every time I speak to Norm Kent, he's like right on the edge of his seat, and he's worried that this one just got injured, and his rotisserie league is falling apart, and Mitch Webster's back in the lineup. And... it's incredible.
He's in conference.
Yeah, he's in conference on rotisserie baseball. He's trying to trade for Sean Dunston now that he's hitting. Yeah,
that's
he's
what it turned out to be.
Out of
he's
his mind.
Very important. He's in the
The man is a great attorney, but he's living his second childhood in baseball. Okay, that's all I can tell you. Miami, hello.
Hey, Neil, what's hanging?
Hey,
what's going on?
What's going on, pal?
Nothing much. That guy Tim sounds like a real, sounds like the bottom of a taxi cab.
Yeah. Scraping the bottom of the barrel.
Oh, hey. I just heard Alice, and she just put me into a slight coma.
Alice? It's a little early for Alice, isn't it?
Well, yesterday she put me into a slight coma.
Oh, yesterday he was drinking that,
Hey, Neil, can I hold on for the lightning round?
I knew you sounded like the kind of guy who ought to ring.
You know who this is, right?
Yeah, you know who it is. Just put him on. Just put him on.
Just hold him.
No, it's not who I think it is.
Yes, it is.
Fabian? Oh, sure. I'm in a good mood today, Fabian. We'll even put you on for the lightning round, okay? And if you should get disconnected, don't blame me. It'll be an act of God. Oh, man. Is he something? He's like, who's the other one? Like Veg. One of those people you cannot insult. You know, he just keeps coming back and coming back for more.
Mm-hmm.
Reminds me of that guy with the blue car. Bob something, who used to come in the morning and win those prizes.
Oh, yeah, from Sun...
Sunrise.
Bob from Sunrise, right?
Oh, boy. He even shows up on the remotes.
Does he?
Oh, man. Just cannot get rid of that guy. He's just so creepy and so...
Spooky.
Yeah, spooky. Here are the classics four now. And one of Bill Wise's favorites. One of his picks for the week. Miami, hello.
Hello.
You want to hold, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I can tell by the sound of his
voice. How many on hold now? We need to keep track.
2, 4, 6.
Six
There's
on hold?
There's only 8 lines, and one of them's blank.
6 are on hold?
6 out of the 7. It leaves West Palm Beach. Do you want to hold, sir?
Yeah, please, Neil.
Okay. Well, I guess that kind of backs us into a corner now.
No, that's fine. That's all right.
What? Well, it's just about time.
Yeah, I know it is.
It times out pretty well. I will say this. Boca's not... Oh, there it goes. Just as I said it, it started to flash. Hello?
Yeah, can I hold the lightning?
Sure, no problem. Okay, now we're all set to go. We'll do our last break, and then we'll come back and have a good, exhausting lightning round, and then we can say...
What a bark!
Right. Wow, what a show today. I was right. And the lunch from Wings Plus today, I am going to tell you. Boy. I still can't get over it. It was like something that happened, but then you have to wonder whether you dreamed it or it really happened. That's how good it was.
Yeah. 48.
Sharon came in again, and she made a disgusting comment about Ross's lips again, which I cannot believe. And
don't get me in trouble.
Or was it Batman and Robin and his lips? You have an obsession with lips.
Yeah,
so if there are any guys out there
that
really like Steve Tyler lips, Sharon is ready to meet you in the hallway.
Mick Jagger would be good.
No, not good enough. Anyway, Johnny Dark, before we go to the lightning round, has got another incredible story. You want to tell us on the air?
Why come on. Well, we're going to tell it if you don't.
Why wouldn't you want to tell that story? Oh, he wants to get hired over there.
No, he doesn't.
He wouldn't want to work for them.
No, he doesn't want to work.
Anyway, he was over there visiting our good dear friend Jeff Gonzer, picking up his acid casualty t-shirt that he won in the Immortal show.
True.
Since John could get right through, since there are only 2 or 3 people dialing in. And he was in chatting with Jeff, who, of course, is so amiable that it's usually disgusting. And Rose Folger came into the control room and said, well, it's nice seeing you, John. Goodbye. You're going to have to leave now. Kicked his ass out of the building.
Jeez.
You think there's a little paranoia there?
Yeah, very.
Just a little bit of paranoia over in Carroll City?
You betcha.
Sure sounds like it to me. What the hell did he ever do to them? I mean, just because he repeats everything to us that he finds out over there, that's beside the point. If you've got nothing to hide, you know, isn't that what Alexander Haig would say?
Absolutely.
And Ed Meese, if you have nothing to hide, then just open up the doors to the closet. Let's see what's going on there, okay? Right?
Exactly.
Because since I was fired by Tim Williams, my life has really turned upside down. I just cannot believe that the man would have the chutzpah to say that, especially a guy with young children like that. It's 10 till 2 at WIOD, and we're ready to go now to this part of the show that most of us are pretty damn embarrassed by. Dade County, hello.
Hello, Neil.
Palm Beach.
Yeah, Crawl Pepper, second day in the ground, things are just fine.
Never felt better in my life. Broward, hello. Dade County, hello.
Zagaki's an ass.
Dade County, hello.
I'm constipated over here.
That's a nice...
Was that Tim?
Yeah. That's a nice...
Oh, that voice sounded pretty familiar to me.
Good one.
Boca, hello.
Of course, I don't make love as well when I'm constipated.
They go together, see? In
Broward, hello.
Nick, you're a pencil neck geek.
Another member of the Nick Lawrence fan club. Dade County, hello.
Ever since Bill Calder moved to New Orleans, he's become a Cajun provocateur.
The Bat Line.
You're a bastard.
By the way, bring our carts back when you're finished in the newsroom, okay? He's inside, house call. Broward, hello.
There was an old lady who lived in the shoe. She...
Dade County, hello.
Hello? Bird?
Palm Beach.
Hello? I'd like a nice, big, juicy ham sandwich.
Boca.
See, every time on this roll.
Dade County, hello. This is good. Just buzzers, okay? This is a new way to do it. Broward, hello. Boy, are they sharp as a marble today, huh?
Boy.
Wow.
A little slow.
Yeah. Just a little slow. Well, I think that heavy news we got this hour, I think they're just under the under the weather, under the table. The bat line.
Is Emily Aiken?
Dade County, hello.
Uncle Neil, pull my finger.
Palm Beach.
Bird, you've got the personality only a necrophiliac could love.
Okay.
That sounded like the Hunchback of Notre Dame, didn't it? 152 at WIOD.
Yeah.
There's one, there they go, flashing again.
See, this is good. You get to hear all the ones that are dumped, which you normally don't
get a chance to
hear. You don't get to hear these on the air. What a
loser. Perfect.
Yeah, perfect for that idiot. Okay, sir, you ought to be boiled in oil, okay, you jackass, you idiot. Broward, hello.
I am not a happy Mets fan.
Just wait a couple hours if you think it's bad now. Palm Beach, hello.
This is Tim Williams.
Slow as usual. Just kind of dragging along.
Yep.
Dave Broward, whatever.
Steve Kane, you're a dork.
Oh, wow. Twist on the dork lady there, huh? She's
like
up to new...
I don't like her changing now. I like the way it was. I don't like... changed.
I think
like
it was Dork Lady Juniorette.
Was it Dork Lady Junior?
Or was it the Dork
I wonder
lady?
If she won a dinner yesterday. On the show that they're
Dork
still
lady.
Talking about all over town, that show yesterday. Boy, you ought to hear what they're saying.
We can't
put
say
it
on the
air,
no.
Palm Beach.
Hey, Neil, if you show me yours, I'll show you mine.
No big thing there. Dade County, hello.
Jeff the Sebastian Sale name.
Broward, hello.
Billie Jean's a douchebag.
Dade County, hello.
My name is Al Rantel, but my friends call me Freeway.
Boca, hello.
Tim, does Tim Williams sink or float?
Excellent question,
yes.
Sir.
Yes.
Dade County, hello.
I'm falling and I can't get up.
Backline.
I'm getting laid over here.
Yeah, you wish.
Yeah. Likely story.
Mm-hmm.
Boca, hello.
Hello, Anna Maria? Are you there?
A little traffic call there on the... Oh, boy. She's right on top of things, isn't she? And if she ever gets off, we'll get that traffic on. Dade County, hello.
Neil, you know millions fired your ass.
Broward, hello.
Who's on tour longer, Claude Pepper or The Who?
It's pretty tight, pretty tight. Palm Beach.
The Mets suck.
All right, finally a caller with some sense. Batline.
You make me puke.
Dade County, hello.
Twinkle, twinkle, twinkle.
Broward, hello.
Wiggle, wiggle.
Dade County, hello.
I'm having chest pain.
Palm Beach.
On the line at the Roscoe House in Woodside.
Dade County, hello.
Jails, people are assholes.
Okay, boy, that's a constant truth. Boca, hello.
Jill, have you ever seen Eve Arden and Vincent Price in the same place?
Batline, hello.
Well, isn't that special?
Dade County, hello.
The best of Steve Kane is the perfect oxymoron.
Broward, hello. Boy, they are really on top of things today. Palm Beach.
Boynton Beach, Los Neil.
Great.
That's good. Broward, hello. Dade County, hello.
I need the dork lady.
Yeah, I understand.
Boca, hello.
This is Claude Pepper. How many frequent flyer miles does my body have?
You can travel around the world 6 times now, I think, isn't it?
Oh, my.
Dade County, hello.
Yeah, is Hank Goldberg real Neil Rogers at night?
See, at least the one thing with Claude, they did not have his casket hanging half out the helicopter like
right.
the Ayatollah. That's, yeah. At least we had a little class. Broward, hello.
Alex Rantel eats Hmong.
Huh.
Batline.
Wow, Eric Kumaro.
Dade County, hello.
And 2 weeks later, here comes Norman Wolf.
Excellent.
What a pick. Dade County, hello.
Nanette Kaliva sucks.
The what?
Dude? Something sucks.
I don't know. I didn't get it.
Dade County, hello.
Danny, cover up your armpits before we all die.
Palm Beach.
The Mets go suck.
Batline. Okay.
Good one.
Somebody inside the building dropped the phone and the soap at the same time. Mm-hmm. Dade County, hello.
This game makes me want to puke.
Boca.
My crotch itches.
Dade County, hello.
It's slowing down and I can't get it up.
What a bonehead.
Dade County, hello.
Beep.
Well, it happened to be true, but we couldn't let it go.
So you get to hear that.
You wanted me to let that go?
Yeah, there's nothing wrong with that. There isn't.
Maybe on your show. How you know why he's not in the business anymore?
But it was so true.
Hey, well, there's no question. Sometimes just because something's true doesn't mean we put it on the air, okay? Batline. Okay. They're really going nuts inside the building. Too bad we don't have some work for them to do in the
isn't
newsroom.
It?
Broward, hello.
A toast to Al Rentel.
After yesterday's
yeah,
show.
Yeah, perfect.
A little slow on
perfect.
It. Dade County, hello.
Tim Williams sucks.
Now, see, we can let that one go.
Yeah.
Yeah, see, that one...
That was more right on line.
The other one was a little bit more rapid.
Mm-hmm. Dade County, hello.
Very sad!
Batline.
This is Marriott Calder. I want you to come in my box.
Oh,
jeez.
Now you get an idea of what goes on here that doesn't go on the air.
Anyway, it's 1:58 at WIOD.
That was a double entendre, wasn't it?
Yes. Mm-hmm. It certainly was. And when you get your own show, all of the ones that we dump on this show, you can put on your show, okay? You can go over there to Carroll City because they want to be really ethical and right on top of things. Dade County, hello.
I am a douchebag.
Broward, hello.
You make your partner use a condom?
Palm Beach.
Thank God it's over.
Yeah,
yeah, I was thinking the same thing. Dade County, hello. Broward, hello.
We've been Johnny Doc intensive.
True.
Palm Beach.
This case is douchebag.
Dade County, hello.
Happy birthday, choo-choo.
Dade County, hello. Come on, get with it. Too late. A bat line. Boy, isn't it amazing how many people inside the building, I think, are calling. Broward, hello.
Who the hell turned the lights out? I'm trying to get some work done here.
And, of course, in Boca.
Kiss me, you silly fool, you.
Perfect. Okay, well, that's going to do it here for a reasonable Wednesday. And, you know, things were okay. Now on the Steve Kane Show, Yim Tom should lick David Daly. That's the list of guests. I'm reading it right off the page. And then we got sports talk with Hank. Pardon me for using Neil's material, Goldberg, from 6 to 7:30. Then at 7:30, Yankee baseball with the Orioles. And, of course, Larry King tonight's going to breathe on Sammy Davis' eyeball, and it's going to cause a stir that even Murray Puppick wouldn't. Have a great day. I'm going to rush home and watch the Cubs win again, and we'll see you tomorrow morning at 10 here on 610 WIOD. And then he comes in here and rips our sponsor, our dear friends at Wings Plus. Please, now listen, I don't want any of this to go wasted today, because, boy, when we start throwing stuff out, people are starving.
We haven't thrown anything out yet.
Huh?
We haven't.
No, but I'm just telling you. No, we've had days when there's been some stuff that kind of lingered, you know what I'm saying? Oh, these are good and hot today, too. You like it hot? Yeah, right. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, he's from Plant City. He loves it hot. Anyway, there's some chili here, too, which I think I might have a little bit of if we have any. Do we have any utensils? And I'll have a little piece of that sandwich, too. Look at that, boy. We got it all. They went crazy today. There's the forks and the spoon. What is this? Oh, my God. Look at this one today. Have you ever in your life seen a steak and cheese with onion like that? Yeah, I'm having half of that. Who wants the other half? You want it? What do you eat?
No, I'm going to eat wings today.
Just wings?
I think so.
Who wants the other half of this incredible sub? Okay, Cheryl. Cheryl's got this. Where's a plate for Cheryl? I feel like we're in an auction or something here. Isn't this incredible? This is something great today, and it's also kosher with a steak and cheese. Anyway, it's 11:57. This is the part of the show when we kind of shine the audience. You just find something to do out there, okay? Appreciate it very much, and they're a laugh, a scream.
Yeah, underground jingles, I think, something like that.
Anyway, the sub today, the steak, cheese, onion, and now the tomato and the mother cheese.
Boy, that's just like that. That was it, Marlon.
It is great. Yeah, that was Marlon Brando grepsing on the radio. You heard it first. Next, it'll be on Murray Pupik, but you heard it first here. Oh, boy.
You were right about today. This is going to be...
Yeah. This is not just a lunch. I was saying that during the news break. We get fed here every day, but we don't get fed just a good lunch. We get fed a gourmet spread every day. Every single day. It's something sensational.
Time for a crying shames record.
We could play it. Yeah. We got our little 45 spindle on the turntable in there.
Can we play 45s in there, Nick?
Yeah. We can.
Yes.
Now, that's unusual because most radio stations, they steal the spindles every day. You can't. They do. Production studio at Zeta used to drive me nuts. You'd have to run all around the building to try to find a spindle.
I wish you could be here. I want to meet you.
No, I want to hear it could be Warren Lowe.
No. Remember you were in at Zeta?
What? It's the best record they ever made, next up on the roof.
Remember you were in at Zeta one time when Neil was on vacation, John, and you had to, like, center the records because there was no spindle on the 45s?
Yeah, with your fingers.
He, like, centered them with his fingers.
That was incredible.
That's
he did a great
true.
Job of that. Anyway, I got to do a little break while they're queuing up our exclusive Crying Shames record.
That it?
No.
There's more coming.
Okay.
Is there any way you could play May I? And I sure hope she's listening.
We don't have May I. When you get out here, we had no trouble finding the other one.
Oh, yeah. Oh, I wouldn't.
If we had it, we'd play it, maybe.
Yeah.
And Johnny Dark said he'll bring it next time. He's got it.
Mm-hmm. We got it.
Right. Yeah, I'm one of those rare individuals like you were describing.
That's for sure.
But I really have the knowledge of those oldies.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I'd call Ricky Ticky and maybe he'll put you on the air.
Now listen, if you get
your own show over there.
Listen, if you ever want to take my number, I'd be sure to help your radio station out if you ever wanted to play more music.
No thanks. 22 passes on the WIOD. We have an opening in Broward where I just hung up at 524 WIOD. Boy, he was right on the verge of your friend there that was, schmoring in on the show, wanted to sit in, you know?
I know. You hit that button.
Oh, we don't
hard.
Want your number. We're very pleased to talk to you and have a nice life. And
you really hit that off.
Go
us,
play
boy.
With your records, pal.
Bang.
Anyway, we would have played Crying James. Is he dubbing it?
No.
No? Boy, you know, we feed you like this. You think you can just sit around here and dilly-dally? Man. So we would have played It Could Be We're in Love by the Crying Shames earlier. We're going to have to wait a few minutes.
Dub it.
Because we got to dub it on a cart. Because, as John said, our record player is broken.
How can it be broken? That's weird.
Our turntable is under the weather.
Can't believe
I don't understand that.
Me either.
Is this a radio station or what? Turntable doesn't work?
Amazing.
Speaking of sick, here's Chucky.
How you doing, Neil?
Okay.
Who the hell's Johnny Dark? Is he the guy that was on that WKRP in Cincinnati?
Mm-hmm.
And now he's on that head of the class or something like that?
Yeah, that's him.
That's
back
him,
of the
right?
class.
Yeah, I thought so. Anyway, Neil, the Mets suck.
What is that?
The Mets suck.
That's
I finally
correct.
Have to admit it.
Mm-hmm.
But I have won some money on Chicago, so I'm not that
well, good.
Anymore.
Good luck to you.
Yeah. Anyway, can you? That's all. I'm out of material. Can you put me on the lighting round?
Sure, no problem.
Whoa. Wow.
Look at that. Two lines in Broward just went out when we put Chucky on hold. 524 WIOD. Boy, these wings with a blue cheese. This is... Oh, man. Mmm. You've never... I swear to God, I've never tasted anything like this in my life.
Me either.
Mmm. I really apologize to those people who are out there listening getting real hungry.
Yeah.
I don't mean it, but I apologize. Boy, that is something else. Mmm. Wait till they start eating on WLRN.
Don't they already do that? Oh, no.
Yeah, but they eat with forks and knives on there.
Very
refined, okay?
I see.
And, of course, only very British things, you know, because it's pubic radio.
Mm-hmm.
Riviera Beach, hello.
Yes.
Hi. Let me try it again.
Hello.
Neil. Yeah.
Listen. I've been listening to you guys eat and burp and fart on the phone for the last 45 minutes. I wanted you to play Rock Lobster for me.
Rock Lobster?
Yeah, by the B-52s.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is sure the show that plays that kind of stuff all the time.
Right under the table.
That it?
It's a good song.
Yeah. Okay, no problem. We'll get right on for it. Okay, now we're down to four calls. Boy, look at that.
Well,
I think they're all getting hungry and going out for lunch.
Maybe.
She should have.
Yeah, with these calls, it's really okay, you know?
We don't care.
Mm-mm.
Boy. This blue cheese and the... and these are the hot wings, too. He brought medium garlic wings and... these hot or extra hot? Just hot. Mmm. Could be the best thing I've ever put in my mouth.
Now, do you want to think about that?
Yes.
Before you say that?
Well, I've been known to exaggerate.
Embellish. Yeah.
Lately?
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay. All right. I'll buy that.
Mm-hmm.
I'll buy that one.
1226 at WIOD, and we have an open line in Broward, 524-9463, 524-WIOD. And also one in Palm Beach at 655-WYD. Boy, this is the... I haven't gotten any on me, I don't think. But this is the sloppiest job of eating I've ever done. But it's just... You don't care. I didn't get any of those mushrooms. Are they all gone?
I didn't either, and I don't know.
They're all gone?
Probably.
Somebody took all the stinking mushrooms?
They really cleaned us out.
The beer-battered mushrooms or the horseradish sauce?
I didn't get any either.
They're all gone.
We were cleaned out today.
Oh, now let's not get carried away here, folks. I think Mitch took all those mushrooms.
I never
I saw the box.
Never even came close.
There was
to me.
A whole load of them.
Oh yeah.
But I think they disappeared. Oh, we're way behind on a break here, aren't we? My God, what's going on?
You're distracted.
27 past noon. We're like 3 minutes past on a break, and I'm supposed to tell you that.